Okay, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. So this is the first example for the active power, reactive power and also apparent power. Okay, so it is given that the current, okay, the current is given such as I, which is I AC is actually 4 cos omega t minus 100 degrees. And the VT is actually in a sinusoidal form. So we need to convert into a cos. So it will give you 400 cos omega T plus 15 minus 90 degrees. Okay. So this one will give you 100 cos omega T minus 75 degrees. Okay. So, and then by using the RMS, or you can use RMS, or you can use any, you can use this one, this formula, VmIm cos theta V minus theta I, or you can also use the RMS, IRMS, VRMS, IRMS cos theta V minus theta I. Okay, so I think since we have this one is a maximum value, so I will use the first equation here for the active power. Okay, so 1 over 2 multiply with the voltage 100 multiply with the maximum current is 4 ampere, and then multiply with cos the theta V is negative 75. Okay, and the current is actually negative 100, so meaning that this is actually positive 100. So this one will give you 200. Okay, so 200 multiply with cos 25 degrees, so this one will give, okay, the answer of the active power is given 181.26 watt. Okay, so I write the answer here. P is 181.26 watt. Okay, and then you need to calculate the reactive power. So the reactive power Q is 1 over 2 multiply with Vm multiply with Im multiply with sine theta V minus theta I. Okay, so 1 over 2, so 100 multiply with 4 multiply with sine, this one is 25 degrees. So this one will give you 200 multiply with sine 25 degrees. Will give you the answer positive. Okay, so positive 84.5 bar. So I can write down my reactive power is 84.5 bar. Okay, and what is my apparent power? Okay, so my apparent power is simply you just multiply the voltage RMS and the current of RMS. Okay. Okay, so apparent power, which is S, you can calculate by using this formula, VRMS multiply with IRMS conjugate. Sorry. The apparent power. So the apparent power is actually S just multiply the VRMS multiply with the IRMS. But also you can also use this one, 1 over 2 Vm multiply with IM actually. It's actually similar because we know that BRMS, IRMS is actually BM over square root 2 multiply with IM square root 2. So square root 2 multiply with square root 2, you got 2. So it's actually equivalent. So you can use this one or this one. So since we have maximum value here, so I am using this formula for to calculate my apparent power. So my apparent power should be just a very simple calculation. So actually 100 multiply with 400 divided by 2. So 200, the unit is VA. Okay, and what about the power factor? So the power factor is actually, you know, is actually a cos sine of theta V minus theta I, and we have already calculated it. So actually cos theta V minus theta I is actually the 25 degrees. Okay, so you can calculate by using calculator. So cos 25, so it will give you 0.906. So you have already got the cos factor, the power factor, okay? The power factor, which is cos theta V minus theta I. But right now, can you give me what is power factor? It is lagging or leading? So which one? So how to determine this power factor, whether it is lagging or leading, is actually by looking at the sign of your reactive power. So right now your sign of the reactive power is a positive. So positive meaning that this one is actually inductive. The circuit is actually inductive circuit, meaning that when inductive, so automatically it is actually the power factor is actually lagging power factor. Okay, so that's all for example one. Thank you very much for your attention, and we will continue to the next lesson.